Lovelies, it's me, Sherry, with Live Love Latte, and thanks for joining me for this current projects update video. I uploaded a video on November 7th at the beginning of my repainting my whole house and redecorating, and so this is kind of an update of a few of the rooms. Now, it's been about 2 months, but there were a couple weekends, honestly, I just didn't want to do anything, and then there were a couple ones where my kids and I decluttered and organized the garage, although that's not yet finished. And I've repainted a few rooms. My family has helped me here and there, and my husband is now helping me by taping a lot of the areas, in fact, most of them. And then there are a few rooms where I really still want to redecorate. It's not exactly the way I want it, but you know, it's always just a process. But I want to get it to where I'm happy, where I don't have to think about it for a while. So here we go. This is the first room that I worked on. This is the kitchen nook right off of the kitchen. You can see the beautiful windows there into our desert scenery here in the Southwest. The main thing I did here, aside from painting the walls, and it is called Dunn Edwards Miner's Dust in an eggshell, and the lady at Dunn Edwards helped me choose the color. She basically gave me two choices and she just picked the right color for me. I was telling her that my house is now beige and wrought iron and brown, and so she gave me a more, I guess you call it a brown undertone gray. So the one I wanted was a very cool gray, and she said it would contrast too much. You'd want to change your tiles and everything, and you know, it'd be too overwhelming for you. And she was totally correct, so I appreciate her very much. I also decided to take everything off of the wall. So there was a wrought iron mirror here. There were there were matching wall decor there. And then my table didn't have the leaf in the middle, so I put the leaf back in. And I just put together this very simple centerpiece with a capiz shell that's from the Philippines, placemat, this, what do you call that? Galvanized, that's the word. So kind of a galvanized tray with wood in it, and then I still have my salt and pepper shaker birds, and then I have this little galvanized pail, and I put the napkins in there, and then this orchid that I think I got from Goodwill. So this is the area, and then I also, so all that stuff on the wall is taken off, and then I also had my menu that I had DIY'd a few years ago here. So I took that all off, and then, oh, gotta take this off. It was raining and dripping a little bit yesterday. So I love how the previous owners put this, the same granite countertops on the windowsills here. So I think that's beautiful. Here's my bird of paradise. And then it's been raining all day yesterday, raining today, but I was like, I have to film today because I don't have time the rest of the week. But this is our view from the kitchen. Let me see if I can show that to you. And when it's a clear day, over there are the mountains. That's a fountain. Maybe one day I'll give you a tour of my backyard. So this is my kitchen nook, just as undecorated and simple and decluttered as possible. Go, here's Molly. Say hi, Molly. And look at Molly, what she did. She got one of the paint rollers, and that's like her new toy now. Hi, Molly. Hi, Molly. Hi, Molly. Hey, Molly. She's looking for her toy. I put it away because it's squeaking, and I needed to do this video. So anyway, here is the family room, again, repainted. So my husband and my son actually helped me with this room. Thank goodness, because this took a few hours, because I figured out one wall of one coat is an hour. So it's at least two coats, so that's 2 hours. So two, four, you know, the six plus the kitchen, that this probably took 6 hours. This one used to be green and I had to prime that. So 2 hours just to prime, because you have to let it dry in between, and then another two coats. So that's why it takes long. So if you've ever painted, you understand that. Okay, so that's the main thing. I painted everything the same gray, miner's dust. I've had those lamps. I've had this table for over a decade, and you can see it's totally worn out. And I love this brown leather couch from Z Gallery. Now, I've tried to make it as gray as possible, so you see the throw blanket there, There's some pillows with different textures. And I just love this. It says hello. I think I got that from Home Goods just a little while back. And that's my husband's table over there. So for now we have the humidifier, but that's not year round. Then I just have logs in a basket and I just keep logs there just so it's ready for a fire. I've had those candles forever in that mirror, and I just wanted this mantle also to be very simple. And then also the mantle I painted, this used to be brown. Again, I'll insert any pictures of befores that I can find. And now, and she suggested, the same lady at Dunn Edwards suggested this color. It's called Whisper Gray. That's it. I got the same TV, same shutters, the plantation shutters. It just makes it more light and airy. And then also, I've had this couch. This was from Living Spaces. And yeah, here's the setup I have for the pillows. Another throw, so whoever's sitting here can have a throw. And that's where I sit, so my throw is over there. I think this is Home Goods. And then the one on the other side, I believe this is Ross. So look at that. I just thought, wow, perfect. And I was wondering if I should match the tables on both sides, but I went with different ones. And I am looking for succulents. I might make one to put on both tables. So that's the family room. Here's another overview. And honestly, I really, really like it. We might change the fans, maybe the fan blades to white. I'm not sure yet. Okay, Molly's crying because she wants her toy, so I'm gonna go grab it for her. But here's another overview. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, I wanted to tell you guys. I'll insert a picture here. I'm waiting for this print that I ordered from Etsy. It's the vintage map of Paris from Turgot. You know, the one you see at Restoration Hardware. Well, he had a 30% off sale. Not Restoration Hardware, but this Etsy store called Restoration Maps. It's coming from Canada. So I was thinking, should I wait to film this before I show that? But I said, I'll just show it in the next update video. But it's a big one. It's like 72 inches by 56. I'll get it framed probably in a grayish wood looking, probably like this. I'm not sure. We gotta figure it out. And I'm really excited about this. So can you kind of picture that? Thanks so much for watching and checking out the updates of my current projects. And I will see you in the next one. That's Molly saying bye with her toy. Bye.
Please subscribe to my channel, Live Love Latte, and join me on my daily adventures as a mompreneur.